Hey, I'm Phil for Comunia Tech News. So Miovision is growing and they need a bigger home. So co-founder and CEO Kurtis McBride asked his staff what it was that they were looking for out of a new office.
They wanted to be in the downtown core, but they wanted parking for everybody. They wanted to be close to LRT, close to bike trails, and then they also wanted to be able to keep our production team together. And so when we went out to market with those requirements, we had 15 responses to our RFP, but not a single one of them met the requirements because that building doesn't really exist. You can't have lots of parking right in the middle of downtown and roll transport trucks up to the back of a building.
Trying to find a new space showed Miovision just how tough it is to house a modern hardware company. So when they found a sprawling 475,000 square foot former warehouse on Glasgow Street, it sparked a much bigger idea. They realized that they could help a lot more than just Miovision. They could actually help all kinds of hardware companies in the region with a whole new accelerator that they're calling Catalyst137.
So this will end up having about 30 hardware-focused companies based in it. We're also committed to filling the building up with different types of users that will help to accelerate time to market for hardware companies. So there'll be a contract manufacturer in here, there'll be an RF test lab, IP law, marketing agencies, sort of all the things you need to get a hardware company to market quickly.
Of course, a big part of growing a modern successful company is attracting the right talent. And this is a problem that real estate developer Frank Voisin has thought about a lot.
This room we're in is going to extend all the way back to the wall across the way there, and this is going to be where the coffee shop is. So when you enter, you're going to enter into an area where there's a lot of people sitting at tables, enjoying their coffee, interacting with each other. You'll run into people you know. Just on the other side here, we're calling it the market, and at the west end of the market, there's going to be a restaurant slash brew pub. On the edge of that is an outdoor area, which is covered right now, and so that's going to be a covered eating area for the restaurant. And then just to the other end of the restaurant, down maybe 80 feet where the train tracks come into the building, and that's contemplated to be a gym that would be for the tenants but also for the local community. So we're trying to draw people in and make this a place that's not just about tech users but something that the community feels it's something for them as well.
Catalyst 137 is going to be focused on developing IoT or Internet of Things hardware. And I asked CEO Kurtis McBride if it makes people nervous when they think about IoT as sort of internet-connected fridges and microwaves.
I think what often happens with these sort of hype cycles at the beginning of the cycle, people don't exactly know where the technology is going to take us. So they speculate and they pick things they know, like a connected fridge. The truth is what usually happens is the things that ultimately manifest themselves are things you couldn't have predicted, that they're totally new things. So you think about the internet in 1995, you know, people were trying to imagine what it was going to mean. No one could have guessed Bitcoin and Amazon and eBay and things like that. So I think Internet of Things is in a similar part of its life cycle where we're starting to see some examples of where it can be applied. But I think it's going to be a lot more interesting than we imagine today, but we won't get to know what that means for another 10 years probably.